In honor of the victorious journey of our learners and their parents during this time of pandemic, we welcome all of you to the virtual graduation rites of Clavar National High School with the theme Strengthening Quality Education Amid COVID-19 Pandemic.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us all stand for the Philippine National Anthem to be followed by an opening prayer by Romer John G. Intinia with High Honors ABM. And please remain standing for the Division Hymn and School Hymn.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Hayang mag-ibig, Diyos ng sinahanan, alam ng puso sa titik mo'y buhay. Upang hinirang, tuyag ka ng magiting, sa mandulupin, di ka pasisigil. Sa nagatak, tutok sa simoy at sa langit kong pangraw, ay hinatang tulakawin sa pagkayang minamahal. Ang isang nakumatawag mo'y tatu, ang pituwin at araw niya kailan ang may di matitinig. Luman ang araw ng buwan, aking pagsinta, buhay langit sa piling ko. Aming ligaya na pagkay, mga amin, ang pamatay ng dahil sa'yo.
Today, as we celebrate what we have been and will become, we pray that God's blessing may cover each of us in a cloak of love and safety. To all the Roman Catholics, let us do the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, you are eternal, immortal, and invisible. You alone are God. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You are the biggest and the most beautiful and the most powerful. Heavenly Father, we apologize for any mistakes we have committed into you throughout our journey in this new learning system. And despite this pandemic, Father, we are grateful for the opportunity to engage in this kind of activity. This endeavor serves as a recognition for all the things that we've accomplished during our 6 years of education from junior high school to senior high school. For all of our new friends, for all of the days of laughter and pleasure, and for all the times of wonderful discovery and learning, we thank you for everyone who has contributed their time, talent, and enthusiasm so that we can graduate today. Our teachers and mentors, as well as our families and friends, we express our gratitude for them and offer them to you in prayer. Since this chapter of our lives ends and another one begins, we present ourselves to you like an open book. Come, pour your life sentences in our hearts, fill our heads with your ideas. Fill our bodies with your mighty power. Fill our hearts and your dreams so that we might love and serve you forever, today and always. All of this we ask in the magnificent name of Jesus, who lives and reigns eternally with you and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Gentle, loving, and daring people.
To the opening message of Claver National High School head teacher designate Mr. Rodelio P. Cortez.
My warmest congratulations to all graduates and completers, Batch 2021. Welcome to this virtual graduation and completion rites that aims to recognize all your triumphs in your high school life, which is undeniably significant and historic. This marks the success of the learners, the teachers, the school, and its stakeholders in adjusting to a new learning modality. Claver National High School has long been known for its sincere commitment to quality education, an educational institution that believes in the importance of partnerships and shared governance. This is the reason why for the past years, Claver National High School has established strong ties with its partners and stakeholders. When the COVID-19 pandemic came into play, majority of the schools in the country succumbed to its highly challenging circumstances. But Claver National High School, with the help of its partners, stood strong amidst all odds. Dear graduates and completers, this virtual graduation and completion rites is a modest indicator that apart from your perseverance, the school's shared governance with its partners and stakeholders played a big role in enabling you to reach this overwhelming success. Your determination in accomplishing your task in the time of COVID-19 pandemic has finally paid off. Let this major accomplishment in your life be celebrated with your family, friends, and loved ones. Continue to be resilient as you navigate the challenges of a dynamic and globalized society ahead. To our beloved parents, accept my heartfelt gratitude. Thank you for being an effective and efficient partner of the DepEd in the implementation of distance learning. Your untiring support is a deep reflection of the unconditional love you bestowed to the learners through the years. Undoubtedly, you have greatly contributed to the fulfillment of the mandate of the DepEd, which is Solong Edukalidad. Again, congratulations. Wish you all the best in your next endeavor.
To deliver her welcome address for this virtual graduation ceremony, let us all welcome Ms. Narlene Ann M. Hamisula with highest honors, STEM.
My respect and warm felicitation to the ever-supportive Municipal Mayor, Honorable Georgia Digo Kianke, and to the Sangguniang Bayan members headed by the Honorable Vice Mayor Narlito G. Hamisula, to our distinguished and highly esteemed member of the academic community, led by the dynamic and an epitome of an empowered woman, school secondary principal 4, Mrs. Marisol M. Galido, head teacher designate, Mr. Rodelio P. Cortez, to our grade 12 coordinator, Mrs. Marijin P. Villanueva, senior high school coordinator, Mr. Noel A. Picato, and to our school's division superintendent, Mrs. Maria Teresa M. Rial, the Claver National High School faculty and staff, members of the graduating batch, parents, guardians, friends, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant welcoming and joyous day. This day is one of the incredible significance as it marks the end of an era and a new beginning as well for class 2020-2021. I can vividly recall When we first entered the Claver National High School portal, we were extremely excited, at the same time feeling anxious and hesitant. As we journeyed together, we faced and overcome challenges. The lessons we learned inside and outside the classroom will serve to guide all of us for the rest of our lives. We do not stop here. Not even a pandemic can stop us here. This graduation, our personal accomplishment, is an example of how anything is truly possible when we put our hearts and minds into it, despite the new normal modalities of learning. In this unprecedented time, what lies ahead of us will never be easy. There will be missed exits, roadblocks, as nothing worthwhile is ever easy, and that includes making the most out of our futures. And so today, I take great pleasure in welcoming you all in this very important occasion, our graduation ceremony. Fellow graduates, may the years to come be ever kind to all of us, and may the good Lord with His infinite wisdom bless us with success. Thank you very much, and once again, welcome and good day.
Together, let's hear the message of our very own school principal for Mrs. Marisol Moleta Galido.
Congratulations, class of 2021. So pleased and proud to see you accomplishing great things, especially under the pandemic situation. You have faced courageously this traumatic situation and have established a strong character in going through the experience. Class of 2021, you have finally made it. This is your time to enjoy the celebration and possibilities for the future amidst the COVID-19 pandemic. Keep an open heart and mind. Happy graduation. God bless you.
Now let us give an ear to our school's division superintendent, Ma'am Maria Teresa M. Rial.
Let me start my message by sending my warmest greetings and congratulations to the graduates of Batch 2021. Starting the school year 2020-2021 was like stepping into the unknown. We came prepared, but we were uncertain over the next day's state of work, our health, and over other matters that come with providing education in the midst of an unprecedented time. But like real combatants, we fought hard, and with God's divine providence, we emerged victors as you, our learners, completed the curricular year safe and sound. The advent of the pandemic has inadvertently changed our lives in many different ways. We let go of the old and tend to embrace the new normal of seeing and doing things. Challenges have become prevalent as we enter into this stage of transition. Restrictions and limitations. Struggles have become an everyday scenario, especially for the deprived, the depressed, and the underserved who barely could provide themselves with something for survival. Amid this dreadful scare, your health and safety, including your friends and loved ones, is our topmost priority, as nobody is invincible to stop the spread of the virus. Consequently, this health crisis has in a way hampered us to give you the traditional yet memorable graduation ceremonies. Technology has given us the luxury to celebrate this milestone through virtual platforms. Despite the twists and turns of event, more importantly, we learn how to pick ourselves up by not allowing the situation to manage and control our actions and decisions. Instead, we navigated in an attempt to improve it, even in our humble capacity, and we remain focused on the things of value, our education. Apt and relevant, this year's theme, Strengthening the Quality of Education Amid the COVID-19 Pandemic, is bold enough to underscore our efforts that amid all the challenges, the prize won for being relentless and for keeping the sense of focus to continue one's quest for education. What you have achieved today are in themselves gems that must not only be treasured, but should serve now more than ever an inspiration to achieve and dream more in your pursuits. My dear learners, nobody should stop you in chasing your earnest dream for a brighter future. Remember, to succeed in life, you must learn to appreciate wholeheartedly the process as you are preparing for a date with your destiny, your future self. Always keep yourselves interested in every opportunity that comes along your way. Take into heart the counsel of years without losing sight of your purpose on how to make yourself significant in whatever capacities you have. Our success in providing you with quality basic education, despite all the restrictions and limitations we have victoriously overcome, is a living proof that we can do all things when we converge and when we are united. This, I am sincerely most grateful about, because your graduation would not have been possible without the united efforts and unrelenting sacrifices of each and every member of the school community. At this juncture, let me congratulate the school heads and teachers who day after day have unceasingly devoted all their energies in the development, printing, distribution and retrieval of your self-learning modules on top of the many demands of the various programs, activities and projects implemented by our agency. For constantly nurturing our learners to be a better individual, the tireless efforts and time you have devoted just to deliver the goods of education to our learners are in themselves heroic and monumental. Our snappy salute goes with no reservations to all of you. To all the division personnel who have focused on providing technical assistance to schools and on promoting quality education and accessibility in remote schooling has been cleared all along. To our local government units, non-government organizations, and private entities who have been willing to fill the gaps and address some of the needs of the school, we could have never reached this far had it not been for your kindness, generosity, and involvement. To the parents and guardians, our alter ego, your involvement in the education of our children for this year are awe-inspiring and worthy of appreciation. Your unwavering support will always guarantee that our children's dreams are valid. We owe nothing but gratitude. You have never grown weary in providing instructional support at home, and in making sure that all the needs of the children at home are provided. Personally, I thank you for your unwavering dedication to make all the newness of our education system work and to make your respective homes conducive learning spaces for the learners. To our dear graduates, your graduation is God's manifestation of His love and mercy. I salute you for seizing the opportunity of learning while being safe at home, and of course, for making it through. Let not COVID-19 hamper your aspirations. Dream on, and when you do, dream big with a prayerful heart. That ultimately would be your strongest motivation to embark on yet another challenging journey. Stay focused and don't get distracted while aspiring for far better learning opportunities. May the good Lord continue to bless you and keep you safe in your pursuit to bring joy and happiness to your family, friends, and dear ones. To our Almighty God, for letting us see the light from the entire spectrum of darkness. COVID-19 has not led us to defeat. Instead, it ushered us to winning back lost time with families, becoming more grateful to even the tiniest of things, and most importantly, reconnecting with the spiritual selves we in the past took for granted. Once again, congratulations!
Let us now lend our ears to our ever-dynamic and supportive Regional Director of DepEd Caraga Region, Dr. Evelyn R. Fitalvero, CISO 4.
My warmest greetings to all the senior high school graduates of Batch 2020-2021. I share in the joy of your graduation from senior high school together with your parents, school administrators, classmates, teachers, schoolmates, and your entire local community. I send you my heartfelt congratulations. You have been through the toughest period in your student life. Amid the pandemic, you adjusted, you persisted, and you studied hard. You have been tested, challenged, and pushed to the limit. But now, you realize that you have the will to survive any crisis and to live a meaningful life. That's why you made it this far. With your acquired knowledge and skills, you are now ready to move up to another level. That is by going to college or by acquiring specialized skills or by directly joining the labor force and become agents of nation building. With your maturity and self-confidence, you can now make a name for yourselves and become productive members of society. Admittedly, a cloud of unknowing still hovers over your head, but always remember to keep your sights on the cloudless sky. Be assured that an exciting world awaits you after your graduation. Don't allow any crisis to hinder your dreams and ambitions. Continue to hope because things will eventually get better in the future. No pandemic lasts forever, and it cannot outlast your faith in the system and your hope for a better life. What lasts forever is your love for God, for others, and for yourself. As the Bible said, and now, these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. That's found in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13. Celebrate your triumph with deep gratitude for the people who paved the way for you. You still have a lot of growing up to do, May the values that you have embraced through your high school years animate your imagination and creativity. May you become beacons of inspiration to other learners who are following you. With them, you can embark on an exciting adventure of learning and an even more exciting journey toward personal growth and development. You are the future of Caraga. Remember that. You are the future of this nation. Once again, congratulations, my dear senior high school graduates. Mabuhay kayong lahat.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 393 graduates of school year 2020-2021. Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics strand. Bantugan FJ Rio Ray D with highest honors. Hamisula Narlene Ann M with highest honors. Baradillo Kim Christine M with high honors. Buter Rimar M with high honors. Fontillas Aliana Denise D with high honors. Mira Ira Jean R with high honors. Taer Jenny Rose O with high honors. Taripi Vea Hazel Ruby S with high honors. Apas Pal Joshua M with honors. Abandula Christian V with honors. Aklan Arnold Ross A with honors. Arcolar Warren Chris O with honors. Arecto Famela C with honors. Areza Lance Raphael P with honors. Atsuela Karen Joy E with honors. Baradillo J D with honors. Bayang Griffin M with honors. Bernados Franklin O with honors. Kabuga Angel Adrian S with honors. Kanumay Imaros A with honors. Dal Jenrich M with honors. Intok Rika Mariel A with honors. Escobal Demwal N with honors. Escutin Ronan J S with honors. Galanida Rachel Gay M with honors. Galinato Maria Regal D with honors. Galindez Jolan Angel C with honors. Gilapon Cedric Lowy C with honors. Gibao Eugene E with honors. Hamisula Pullen Grace A with honors. Lambos Tiza C with honors. Ligaya Christiandale P with honors. Malto Lirio Anferni D with honors. Onayan Jonas P with honors. Pakatang IG Psych Sydney P with honors. Paglinawan Gerald with honors. Panilag Haname M with honors. Priscilla Angel May A with honors. Priscilla Roname A with honors. Sakan Elmar D with honors. Satokea MRVB with honors. Savalbaro Crystal John W with honors. Tejero Lister John P with honors. Virai Maria Via Bianca L with honors. Ibanez Romanic C with honors. Galinato Jerome B Monton John Lloyd A. Verdon Justin F. Advisor, Mary Jean P. Villanueva. Co-advisor, Noel D. Picato.
Accountancy, Business and Management. Dicap, Marie Ella Jugel O. with high honors. Intinia, Romer John G. with high honors. Paminta, Jessen May Q. with high honors. Toyor, Micaela A. with high honors. Acibis, Geraldine S. with honors. Acibis, Hannah Joy B. with honors. Bilaya, Rega Rose N. with honors. Katong, Rilan Zandi G. with honors. Dal, Shikina Glory A. with honors. Dalagan, Kenji P. with honors. Digilia, Danica S. with honors. Inaldo, Jacqueline L. with honors. Iskutin, Jake D. with honors. Galos, Basil Danica L. with honors. Hida, Liza May S. with honors. Iligan, Meji E. with honors. Ligaya, Jenny C. with honors. Ligaya, Lancy Jean G. with honors. Taer, Ronya Joy with honors. Verano, Jodeline G. with honors. Gasulas, Eddie G. Bitito, Mitch A. Bulatag, Mary Jane A. Digala, Ethel Jane E. Doreen and Dektag, ABM 12 Advisor, and Levy Mizel Ardiano, Co-Advisor.
Humanities and Social Sciences Strand. Katulay Vivian Jane T. with High Honors. Fijo Jessica S. with High Honors. Lugo Bianca Gabriel J. with High Honors. Navalio Juliana May E. with High Honors. Oliveros JV B. with High Honors. Parcon Cheryl G. with High Honors. Anchola Mabel E. with Honors. Oxtero Jerusalem P. with Honors. Biko Jerome G. with Honors. Kagampang Carla Jane M. with Honors. Cruz Kyla Giselle Ann L. with Honors. Dagasdas Sherwin P. with Honors. Inaldo Chrisleen S. with Honors. Inaldo Lindy D. with Honors. Ensenada Nicolene S. with Honors. Flores Micaela P. with Honors. Galagala Regime T. with Honors. Galindez Jilly Ann P. with Honors. Gerhio Junmar B. with Honors. Huntila China Rose E. with Honors. Insulat Joya Bell G. with Honors. Lanoy Catherine M. with Honors. Larong Giselle Liza C. with Honors. Larong Kim Christine P. with Honors. Lopez Hannah V. with Honors. Naotan Mark Nino O. with Honors. Utom Regulus O. with Honors. Patilan Geneva A with honors. Patusa Argel Carol E with honors. Picato Judel D with honors. Peruda Karen with honors. Rapisura Mary Fee Mika E with honors. Saldua Gualalin B with honors. Singkol Precious Jean J with honors. Sumido Monica B with honors. Bausing Lennon. Kaga James Earl C. Quarteros Genmar J. Espaldon Jury G. Biliona Michelle C. Galieta Jaslyn C. Montenegro Cherish G. Sabalde Risi G. Samontina Christy L. Advisor Alu Y. Badajos. Co-advisor Judeline B. Buhion.
General Academics Trend. Samontina Jean Marie C. with high honors. Adlao Raulito Jr. P. with honors. Andoy Marofel P. with honors. Balasabas Renalyn S. with honors. Biling Jovi D. with honors. Bihag Joanna C. with honors. Kumtapay Earl Joy P. with honors. Daga Christine Janelle L. with honors. Dahaw Rochelle N. C. with honors. Dingding Josephine D. with honors. Dionisio Rezel P. with honors. Intinia Lizelle C. with honors. Galinato Rosemarie with honors. Galvi Mary Jane S. with honors. Garachico Leslie N. J. with honors. Handayan Jean Christine May G. with honors. Larasi Angelie F. with honors. Lianeras Maria Chelsea L. with honors. Lopez Jessa Faye R. with honors. Magpatok Abigail C. with honors. Mindahaw Angeli B. with honors. Obidinsyo Marjorie B. with honors. Oinal Joylyn May P. with honors. Onyut Bichi Pearl G. with honors. Palma Joanna A. with honors. Parahis Charlene N. with honors. Parejo Mary Angel P. with honors. Pisao Christine S. with honors. Piapi Charlie Ben with honors. Ramoso Gerald S. with honors. Riambunanza Hessel Ann B. with honors. Salto Kate S. with honors. Tagle Dana Faye M. with honors. Vega Kimberly O. with honors. Itak Christy May S. with honors. Acero Anthony. Aliukod Burns Charles M. Bedra Rico S. Bulawin Jemboy S. Cabanez Charles Anthony S.
Cagata, Rovic C. Claverol, Jerome I. Dapusala, Angelo D. Ilipi, Meljoy B. Irazo, Adrian S. Galgo, Brial S. Galigao, Jeric M. Galindez, Anthon Jeff L. Gay, Daniel Mark G. Hamil, Elton John S. Malinaw, Jovic A. Malto, Adams Jade L. Mendez, Patrick Jr. L. Napuko, Adrian G. Naki, Brian G. Paglinawan, Charles P. Palermo, Dexel D. Panunsyalman, Jmark M. Pacquiao, Belmer S. Parahis, Ronald B. Pipito, Giovanni M. Kinyo, Raymart W. Rilieta, Imar E. Sahol, Ruleto A. Salinas, Froilan, Jazreel L. Sanchez, Ed, Justin, C. Tanduyan, Gian Refni, S. Aro, Eloisa H. Asutilia, Rica May, L. Bausing, Jana Aizel, B. Baila, Mary Claire, L. Binias, Renalyn G. Bitanio, Jean Rose J. Katong, Yulalen S. Quares, Nordalen G. Dapusala, Micah May N. Esperon, Ladimay P. Galanida, Lorenz A. Gales, Rena N. Lapinia, Shireen C. Lareza, Rigilin L. Larong, Jane Rich C. Legazpi, Charmaine E. Mateo, Samantha Angelica S. Mendez, Patricia Marie L. Nahial, Karen P. Napuko, Diane B. Ocon, Janeth Z. Oxymar, Rode Marie P. Oinal, Ira May V. Paglinawan, Irene B. Pahe, Giselle E. Paminta, Christine Joy S. Pila, Sarah May S. Sabandal, Anna Marie O. Sabaris, Jelly S. Sal, Rachel T. Saranza, Rachel Iris Joy P. Sumailo, Annalisa A. Tadim, Flora May A. Villaverde, Laura Jane P. Michelle Joy G. Solante, Advisor. Jessel Lu M. Cinco, Advisor.
Hairdressing, beauty care, wellness massage. Wagpaw Dialind, with honors. Awa Jefferson. Bahan Eric L. Kirikiri Almar S. Acebes Jasmine A. Alcantara Kathleen. Almanza Jean KZG. Amosog Aina Joy D. Bantugan Elaine. Iligan Tisha Kyle U. Mendoza Angeli O. Molyanida Mona Lisa S. Timon Irene Joy C. Pedraza Shemabel P. Advisor Charles John G. Ercilio.
Home Economics Cookery Bread and Pastry Production FBS. Galacio Yusel M. with honors. Galgo Maria O. with honors. Polvorosa May N. with honors. Vitor Jonalyn with honors. Acero Jr. Alberto R. Avenido Kenneth J. Kensho Rudel. Katipol Michael G. Inaldo Glenn Michael G. Erazo Brian Kent E. Galgo Lemuel V. Garcia Francis Christian. Garcia Marlui G. Larong Ryan. Ligahi John G. M. Nugalo Junri L. Ocon March Ayan G. Paminta Kenneth B. Piapi Ricardo Jr. S. Salabi Ariel S. Sulapas King John A. Sulapas Larry B. Tiwana Kenneth S. Victoriano Ruel G. Villaverde Erickson L. Yamit Elson L. Asido Marvi. Bakara Mercy D. Baila Allen Jane L. Baila Christine May L. Bibirino Regine A. Biling Emeline R. Biling Romery G. Bukilon Krisha Lorraine G. Australia Sarah Jane. Etchon Angel May G. Habay Michaela Jean. Hapos Diana Princess A. La Manilaw Anime L. Linaga Sofia T. Miralles Gemma B. Montenegro Mary Joy G. Napana Mikey P. Ortiz Sherelle T. Patan Trixie R. Picato Lydia May M. Politico Alicia J. Rodes Regin May B. Rosales Donita Rose L. Roselio Marley. Rumayana Crisia Cafe. Sagaad Andrea Jean J. Sinday Kizeya Nicole M. Socuano Jessica E. Sumbilia Anna Rose C. Tigis-tigis Ivana Jeans B. Vicente Jeremy A. Joanne Di Basol Advisor. Ellen S. Villanueva Co-Advisor.
Information and Communication Technology CSS. Apalisis Naomi P. with honors. Baradilio Angel May P. with honors. Berong Ira L. with honors. Berong Cariza P. with honors. Berong Giselle P. with honors. Kagasan John Kiano R. with honors. Escaro Sarah J. with honors. Galgo Eduardo Jr. B. with honors. Lamanilaw Nessa May with honors. Legaspi Marjorie M. with honors. Mondia Archel J. L. with honors. Natad Renaline P. with honors. Obedensio Ranmar Cray A. with honors. Orinshada Angel Rain B. with honors. Otugay Shane Angela R. with honors. Padilio Janessa P. with honors. Rico Edalberto G. with honors. Rodriguez Kirby J. A. with honors. Abad Roldan L. Abonero Robert L. Asumen Richmond John C. Balasabas Selmar C. Bayang Chris Joseph M. Cam Allison Dave T. Dikap Rix Marjan. Alipi Mulkey B. Escutin Daniel S. Fernandez Michael Roy E. Ferrer Joe Marie C. Galgo John J. E. Hedy Kenny P. Ibao Arlivi O. Intong Charles John M. Lato John Herbert L. Mansili James Patrick N. Nahial Christopher T. Navalio Mackey A. Pabustan Roniel S. Pasqua Daryl V. Patosa Prince Carl G. Romero Kim John L. Samantina JB Iverson A. Season Mark. Subiri Sherwin S. Sumailo Anthony James. Tuda Kenth Noah E. Yanez Deyuril. Ahmed Ronisha P. Baredo Blair Hillary B. Ensenada Jonah May T. Gasulas Donna Liza L. Paglinawan Diana Rose S. Paglinawan Rica May R. Pahi Jean Rose L. Bihar, Jamaica. Advisor, Jasmine E. Bano. Co-advisor, Jordan D. Buhion.
Industrial Arts, EIN. Electrical Installation Maintenance. Bernal Celso Jr. M. with honors. Dicap Raymond B. with honors. Rosales Roger L. with honors. Kipanis Justin Paul J. with honors. Acero Chad Mark E. Andoy Aljon B. Antiola Juriel L. Bulawin Eddie Jr. T. Katong Ed Ryan J. Komandante Giovanni L. Dupenio Ryan B. Inaldo Arnold A. Intok Christian J. G. Intok Ray E. Espinol Vito Jr. L. Galagala Romy T. Galanida Daniel B. Galanida Raymart G. Galgao Ronifel G. Galinato Guarnel K. Galos Antonio Jr. G. Gasapo Dan Clefford. Dialogo Mark E. Giritan Gilbert A. Ibarra Patrick F. Hamilo Rolidib A. Ladroma Angel Philip B. Lamanilaw Justin L. Lopez Edgar Jr. B. Mayagma Brian Archie E. Mundihar JV D. Nahiyal Gerald B. Nasayaw Gabriel Jr. U. Nino Franco J. Y. Udtuhan Robert Hill C. Upusa Alejandro T. Parahis Charles G. Pusang Rajan L. Romero Rhino A. Sabandal Johnny Van R. Sabandal Jomar B. Saldo Dennis A. Salad Januel D. Salvo Melvin L. Samuntina Paolo C. Simborio Lendon T. Suberi Joshua S. Orbistondo Mark Francis M. Vertedazo Jobert Nail V. Yamit Ryan Dave C. Ram J. Q. Ukindo Advisor. To introduce our keynote speaker to this virtual graduation ceremony of Clover National High School, let me call in Micaela Toyor with High Honors ABM.
My respect to our school principal for Mrs. Marisol Moleta Galido, head teacher designate Sir Rodelio P. Cortez, beloved teachers, parents, fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen, a pleasant day to one and all. It is my honor to introduce to all of you our guest speaker for this graduation ceremony. He was born on January 2, 1988 in Surigao City and is the eldest child of Mr. Florencio Madamba Bantugan Jr. and Mrs. Rebecca Dalubatan Bantugan. He finished his elementary education at Clover Central Elementary School, Batch 2000. He is a proud alumnus of Clover National High School who graduated third honorable mention in the year 2004. He was acclaimed as Mr. CNHS 2004. He was also awarded as Mathematician of the Year. Aside from that, he landed first place in Regional Techno Quiz and 4th place in the national level at Iloilo City. He was also a gold awardee in the MTAC Metrobank Math Challenge and 5th placer in the regional level. After graduating from high school, he finished Bachelor of Arts in Philosophy at St. Paul University, Surigao, Marechal Magbalantay College Seminary in the year 2009. He then took up AD Theology at St. Augustine Major Seminary at Tagaytay City and graduated magna cum laude. After finishing AD Theology, he then proceeded to law school at the University of San Carlos, Cebu City. Luckily, on his first day, he emerged as one of the successful examinees in the 2018 bar exams. He is now a full-fledged lawyer. On July 8, 2019, he worked as technical assistant in the office of the Deputy Executive Secretary for Finance and Administration, Office of the President, Malacañang Palace. On January 8, 2021, he was appointed by President Rodrigo Roa Duterte with a permanent designation as Director 3 of the same office. Last June 14, 2021, the Assets Management Office of the Office of the President was entrusted to his care as its Acting Director 4. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you our beloved guest speaker, the person who believes that excellence, humility, faith in God, oneself are the keys to success. Attorney Florence June Dalubatan Bantugan. A round of applause, please.
To our principal, Ma'am Marisol Moleta Galido, head teacher designate, Sir Rodelio P. Cortez, beloved teachers, proud parents, guests and visitors, especially to our graduates, good day. My heartfelt congratulations to the CNHS 2021 graduates. I'm supposed to deliver a message last year. It was all set, but pandemic strikes. Nobody anticipated it, but maybe looking at the bright side, this is the right time to deliver my message where our youngest brother in the family, Budik, will be graduating as well. I heard that he has to be elected twice as SSG president to do his job the right way. Kidding aside, allow me to start my message by sharing with you my favorite story on the meaning of success, the life story of Eric Liddell. On January 16, 1902, Eric Liddell was born in China to Scottish missionary parents. During his adolescence, he developed a love for track and field sports. At the 1924 Summer Olympics in Paris, Liddell refused to run his favored 100-meter dash because they were held on a Sunday. He believed that Sundays are made to be a holiday. Instead, he competed in the 400-meter run held on a weekday. Although not specifically trained for 400-meter run, he managed to win the race. When interviewed, Eric Liddell emphasized that being a champion of a race makes me a winner of only one phase of my life. How I live my life after crossing the line is what really matters. Later, Eric Liddell returned to China to serve as a missionary teacher. Dear graduates of the CNHS, despite the success you have achieved right now, let us not lose our focus to the things that really matters. We may have various priorities in hindsight. However, one should put emphasis on the genuine joy that could last for a lifetime. Now that you have graduated the K-12 program of the government from our beloved alma mater, kindly assess yourself in all honesty the questions. How do I live my life now? What are the things I want to achieve for? Where do I go from here? Since you are now at the crossroads of your life, guidance to the right direction is evenly significant. To suggest a few, let me share this acronym, GROWTH, to help you aid in your decision. GROWTH stands for G for goals, R for reality, O for obstacles, W for way forward, T for theocentered, and H for health conscious. Let us discuss this in seriatim. First, goals. First and foremost, think of your destination. It answers the questions, what do I want to become in the near future? Probably to become a lawyer, a doctor, a politician, a police officer, a business person, or a teacher. But what is important is to have a goal. To travel without a goal is like a ship without a direction. It is just a matter of time that it will run aground and eventually sink. One does not start its journey in a step. It all starts with a goal in mind. Having a goal in mind would help you step rightly the first time around. Whether it is big or small, difficult or easy, you must have a goal if you want to move forward from point A to point B. Again, the answer to the question, what do I want to become in the near future, will point you to your goal. Second, reality. Having set our goals, discern your current realities. It answers the questions, are my goals attainable? Given my available resources now, can I make it to my goals? What are the possible ways to obtain my goals? As much as possible, do away with hypothetical premises and focus more on your current reality. Make an eye on the possible means achievable by you. If your goal is to set foot in an island, but all you have is a single stick and you are no swimmer at all, how on earth are you going to set foot in the said island alive with a single stick? The point is, you have to be realistic to some extent. To move forward, you must have the possible capacity to arrive in your goals. Again, the answer to the question, are my goals attainable, will point you to your reality. Third, obstacle. Having established our goals, check our reality, now is the time to to think about hindrances. It answers the question, what are my setbacks in achieving my goals? In every life journey, smooth sailing is a myth. Problems and complications are always part of humanity. It is incumbent upon us to determine way ahead the obstacles to our goals. In doing so, we can approach every obstacle with calmness and wisdom. We can see every obstacle as a necessity to achieve our goals in a positive way. Again, the answer to the question, what are my setbacks in achieving my goals, will point you to your obstacles. Fourth, way forward. Having established our goals, check our reality, and determined our obstacles, we have to plan our actions as a way forward. It answers the questions, what are my plan of actions after determining my goals, realities, and obstacles? We do not stop in establishing our goals, realities, and obstacles. We have to keep moving by putting up our own plan of actions. By setting up our plan of actions, it will give substance now, since we will be able to map out our way towards achieving our goals. Again, the answer to the question, what are my plan of actions after determining my goals, realities, and obstacles, will point you to your way forward. Fifth, theos-centered. Having established our goals, checked our reality, determined our obstacles, and defined our way forward, let us not forget to connect to our God. Theos is a Greek word for God. As a spiritual person, it is equally important to nourish our relationship with God. When I was young as you, I dreamed of becoming a priest. I entered the college seminary and made it to theology. I am convinced that God called me to a religious life. But God has a different path prepared for me. He guided me to a path that would make me grow independently. There were frustrations and defeats at the start, of course, but eventually I was able to realign my thoughts and doings in accordance with His will. After all the struggles, all I can say is thank you, God, at the end. So always hold on to God. So when time comes, someone would rock your boat. You have a God to hold on. Sixth and lastly, health conscious. Just like any endeavor, health nowadays is paramount. The sustainability in achieving your goals can slip in any moment when your health will collapse. Even more timely is what is happening now in the world. We are currently facing the COVID-19 pandemic where thousands of people died. Whether rich or poor, young or old, we have to take care of our body. Self-care is not selfishness. It is caring to oneself as we care to others. Let us always be healthy. To succeed, think growth. G for goals, R for reality, O for obstacles, W for way forward, T for theos, centered, and H for health conscious. Always keep it in mind, just as I learned it by heart while I was studying in law school. As Albert Einstein once said, success favors the prepared mind. Let me take this opportunity to give my utmost gratitude to the CNHS faculty and staff. All your hard works and sleepless nights have paid off. I am so proud to be an alumnus of the CNHS. I know the day will come that our dear graduates will feel the same way too. When that day comes, I hope our formula of growth finds a way to help you through. More personally, I would like to congratulate the hardworking parents who tirelessly support the graduates. They are the unseen part of the iceberg. For the countless hours of support and sacrifices, thank you, dear parents, for trusting the faculty and staff of the CNHS in molding and educating your children. Above all, let us thank the Lord for the gifts of life and good health. Let us thank Him considering that the CNHS is continually producing good citizens to our country. Thank you once again. Keep in mind our growth formula, G for goals, R for reality, O for obstacle, W for way forward, T for theocentered, and H for health conscious. Aim high, dear graduates, and God bless the Claver National High School.
To deliver his words of gratitude, here is F.J. Riore D. Bantugan with highest honors, STEM.
To our school principal for Ma'am Marisol Galido, head teacher designate Sir Rodelio P. Cortez, senior high school teachers, fellow graduates, a pleasant day to all. Many of us graduates would probably say that the best senior high graduation is the one being conducted in school where we can personally see the happy faces of our classmates, batchmates, and friends. Especially that in the history of Claver High, this is the first time that a graduation is properly done online. Yes, it is unconventional. Yes, it may not offer the best experience for all of us. But since this virtual grad is forever etched in the online world, I firmly believe that this will serve as our best reminder of how we have triumphed a completely challenging school year in senior high. I just couldn't believe, not even until now, that the learners in the academic track survived from their complex major subjects without the presence of their teachers at home. I couldn't believe that the learners in the Tech Voc track managed to figure out the skills they needed to acquire without the direct instruction of their teachers. Hence, even if we didn't get to feel the kind of best graduation the previous batches had experienced, I can fairly say that we are the proudest. We are the proudest in the sense that we have won a battle that had its own unique challenges. For that reason, fellow graduates, please tell yourself, I am proud of you. To my friends in ABM Strand, you guys might have not experienced the feeling of putting up a business in school, but I know that with your makeshift activities conducted online, you did well. You survived. To my friends in Hume Strand, you guys have made a good exhibit which showcased your ability in writing and in speaking. Please continue to hone that talent. GAS and Tech Voc graduates, you all have remarkably finished all of the prescribed requirements of your chosen course in spite of the crippling effects of the pandemic. To my fellow STEM graduates, classmates, I am very, very proud of you. Guys, STEM cells, please tell yourself, thank you for surviving all of your major subjects in grade 12. Batch 2021 of Claver National High School Senior High School, we may have faced different battles, made different sacrifices, and exerted different efforts in our senior high school stay. I know that we have something in common. That is that we all survived. Despite the new system of learning, we did survive. Our survival in doing all our self-learning modules only indicates that we are now ready for a much more challenging chapter in education. The chapter where we need to be more independent already. The chapter where we also get to part ways, go into different schools, go into different universities, face educational challenges on our own. I know that sounds so scary, but with all of the teachings we have acquired from our alma mater, Claver High, I know that we are ready to face them all. As we bid our high school journey goodbye, let us all acknowledge the people who have been with us in this very, very amazing journey. Our teachers, who undoubtedly poured out their efforts just to make sure that we have understood all of the essential topics of our chosen craft. Thank you so much, ma'am and sir. Thank you to my advisor, Ma'am Mary Jean Villanueva, and to all of my subject teachers, and also not just to the teachers who have been with me in my academic journey, but also in my extracurricular activities. I wouldn't forget the person who has led me to become the good leader of today, Ma'am Catherine Gomosho, Sir Charlito Lopez, and also in the realm of journalistic writing and public speaking, Ma'am Janice Ocon. To all of the teachers or people in Claver National High School who have imparted so many good things in me, thank you so much, Mom and Sir. Also, to our parents who undeniably supported us both morally and financially, thank you so much. To our Mama and Papa, Nanay and Tatay. And above all, to our Supreme God for His divine provisions. Fellow graduates, we still have to walk in a very long path in education. This is not yet the end. There is still more to learn. Therefore, let us continue to show an unyielding passion for learning, because learning never stops. Let us continue to become excellent in everything that we do, not for our own glorification, but for the community that we will serve in the future. Congratulations to all of us, Batch 2021. God bless our next journey in life. And do remember, whenever we face battles in the future, always remember that Claver High has already made us become prepared and ready to conquer them all. Thank you and good day to all of you.
To formally close this virtual graduation rites, here is Rimar M. Buter with High Honors, STEM.
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to conclude today's proceedings with a few words to our graduates. As we proceed to the next chapter of our lives, I offer the following ingredients for success. Things I have observed in people I've known and worked with over the years. First, integrity. If you carry out your responsibility to the best of your ability, people will trust you as a colleague and turn to you for leadership. Next, courage. In the face of adversity and even tragedy, try to remember the reasons for optimism and never be afraid to ask for help. Look after yourself, especially your health, both physical and mental. Third, follow your instincts and curiosity wherever they lead, and broaden your knowledge by reading as much as you can. Embrace opportunities to collaborate. It's the key to our success as a society, and it helps us grow as individuals. Be bold and take risks, and don't let the fear of failure stop you. Failure is a part of life. It's another way to learn. Change is a part of life too. At times, it's frightening, but we should see it as a chance to improve and to test our limits. Above all, enjoy what you do. Take pleasure and satisfaction in what you achieve. Along with the personal characteristics I have mentioned above, this is the key to a happy life. Whatever your next steps, I invite you to see your studies here as a part of a lifetime of learning. And I encourage you to use that learning to leave every situation better when it was when you arrived. Graduates, and now, my fellow alumni of Claver National High School, congratulations. You have worked hard. We have worked hard. We deserve to be proud of this achievement and to take this opportunity to celebrate. Good luck and good health to all of us.
Congratulates the Clover National High School 4th Senior High School graduation rites. Congratulations, graduates and parents.